हेलो ऑल, माई सेल्फ वेदांगी एंड आई एम अ लीगल इंटरनेट लेक्सेस एंड कंपनी। सो गाइज, माई टूडेज टॉपिक फॉर द डिस्कशन इज प्रोफेशनल मिसकंडक्ट ऑफ द एडवोकेट्स। सो एज वी ऑल नो दैट देयर आर सर्टेन स्टैंडर्ड्स, देयर आर सर्टेन कोड ऑफ कंडक्ट एंड एथिक्स दैट नीड टू बी फॉलोड बाई अ पर्सन हु इज इन अ सर्टेन प्रोफेशन। नॉट ओनली इन अदर प्रोफेशंस बट ऑल्सो इन एडवोकेसी, दीज स्टैंडर्ड्स एंड दीज रूल्स प्लेज अ वेरी वाइटल रोल। So we can say that in simple terms, it basically professional misconduct means that acts which are done by the person which seem to be against the professional code of conduct and against the ethics of the profession. This term, the professional misconduct, has basically been defined in the Black's dictionary as the transgression of some established and definite rule of action, a forbidden act or a dereliction of duty. So we can say that misconduct basically means any act which is unlawful in nature and even though it is not inherently wrongful. Before the Advocates Act 1961, we had Legal Practitioners Act 1879. So there is not any such definition of professional misconduct under the Advocates Act. So talking about some of the instances of professional misconduct, these are like dereliction of duty or professional negligence or the misappropriation or providing false evidences and presenting false information and also forcing the prosecution's witness to not to speak the truth. Now there are certain guidelines that have been formulated by the Bar Council of India. Bar Council plays a very important role in regulating the standards and prescribing the standards of professional conduct and the etiquettes. So to exercise this jurisdiction, the Bar Council of India and every state Bar Council has a disciplinary committee, and therefore the Section 9 of the Advocates Act 1961 states that every Bar Council shall consist of 3 members, and out of these 3, the 2 of them shall be the person selected by the council from amongst its members, and the other one shall be a person co-opted by the council from amongst the advocates who possess the qualification as prescribed under subsection 2 of section 3 of the Advocates Act. Also, the section 35 of the Advocate Act deals with the punishment of advocates who are doing any misconduct. Section 35 subsection 2 states that if the State Bar Council receives any complaint and it has a reason to believe that such an advocate whose name is mentioned on its state roll has been held guilty of any professional or other misconduct, then it shall refer that case for disposal to the disciplinary committee, and after that the disciplinary committee of the State Bar Council shall fix a date for the hearing and shall send a notice to the advocate or the advocate general of the state concerned, and the disciplinary committee, after giving them the opportunity of being heard, may order to dismiss the complaint or reprimand the advocate or suspend the advocate for the time as it may think fit, or may remove the name of the advocate from the state roll. Also, under Section 36 of the Advocate Act, it mentions that the Bar Council of India has certain disciplinary powers, and the Disciplinary Committee of the Bar Council of India, while disposing of any of the case related to the professional misconduct, shall follow the procedure as mentioned under Section 35 of the Advocates Act. Also, if any person who is aggrieved by the order of the Disciplinary Committee of the State Bar Council shall make an appeal to the Bar Council of India under the Section 36 within under the Section 37 within 60 days of the notice that has been made to the advocate concerned. Also, Section 49 of the Advocates Act provides for certain etiquettes and certain code of conduct and standards of the professional misconduct that needs to be taken into consideration by the advocates. So, the professional misconduct may contain any act which is attempting by means to practice fraud or any act which is meant to deceive the court by any fraudulent act. Now, in state of Punjab by versus Ram Singh case, the term professional misconduct has been defined in the form of a moral turpitude or an improper or wrongful act or an unlawful behavior or willful in character or a forbidden act. So now, talking about the conclusion part, we can conclude that advocacy is considered as a noble profession and it should follow all the professional standards that are need to be followed by the advocates. Also, the courts have somewhere and in the recent time been dealt with such cases where an advocate has committed the murder of a client. So, taking into consideration such sort of criminal behavior on the part of the advocate, the Bar Council of India needs to implement certain rules and regulations so that the conduct of that person who is showing criminal behavior can be controlled, and also it should impose strict guidelines that shall take into consideration by ensuring that the person no longer acts unlawfully. There must be certain development programs that should be conducted by the Bar Council of India immediately after the enrollment of such advocate, so as to tell them that these are the do's and the don'ts that need to be followed in this particular legal profession. So guys, that's all about my discussion on this particular topic. I hope you all liked my video. If you have any doubts with regard to this video, then you can post in the comment section. Also, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, Lex Click, and we will meet in the next video with a new topic. Till then, bye.